My name is Ryan Maybee, and we are at the J. Rieger & Company Distillery in the old Heim bottling facility. I don't have a key yet. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. So if you're a guest and you're coming here for the first time, you'll be greeted right here at the front desk, and let's say you wanted to take a tour of the whole facility. It's gonna pretty much start over here on the right, where we have about a 4,000 square foot historical display. That's my dog. That's Moose. This is a map of the West Bottoms back in 1895. This is the area where J. Rieger & Company was born back in 1887, really kind of the birthplace of Kansas City. And then we even have a replica wagon. This is how not only J. Rieger & Company would have been delivered back around that time, but it also is how the Heim beer would have been delivered around Kansas City. This is an actual old case of Heim beer bottles. So this was dug up out of an old barn in Iowa. The label here says Kansas City Breweries Company. Kansas City Breweries Company was more or less a consolidation of multiple breweries in Kansas City. As Heim was growing, they merged with some other breweries to become a bigger entity, and that happened in 1905. Then Prohibition happened in 1919 and put them out of business, and so we know it falls somewhere in that window. Now we're going to the production floor. So right here we're in the very center of the building, and this is where the Heim Brewery would have been doing all of their bottling back in the early 1900s, and then shipping the bottles right out the front north dock onto refrigerated rail cars shipped around the country. This is where we distill bourbon and rye on a daily basis. We make our gin, vodka, the Kansas City whiskey, etc. So we've expanded significantly from our original setup in the warehouse next door. We still have our original still right here, 750-gallon Vendome that we affectionately refer to as Sherry. But in addition to that, we've now added this column still, 27-foot column still, which will help us expand our production about by 300%. So we'll be distilling about three times as much whiskey than we were over the last 4 or 5 years. In addition to that, we've increased the fermentation tanks from 800 gallons to up around 3,000 gallons. And we've also added a brand new 500 gallon custom design still for the gin. So that still is brand new, and that will be used exclusively for gin production. I'd take you in there, but they're still doing a little bit of work. This here is our tasting room bar. So this is one of three bars here inside the building. This will be used every day at the end of every tour. So if people come in for a tour, they'll basically land here in this room. They'll taste through all of our products, be led on a tasting, and then after that, they'll be able to go through the gift shop and then upstairs to have a drink if they want to hang around. Did you go down the slide?
Of course.
So this is kind of one of the whimsical, fun things that we've added to the whole experience, is that we want to, you know, kind of convey the message that, you know, we take our products really seriously, we take the history really seriously, but we also don't want to take ourselves too seriously. We want to have fun with it. And I think the slide also kind of embraces the spirit of Electric Park and the amusement park that was just across the railroad tracks here. So this is a fun way for people to hang out, have a drink or two, and get down to the gift shop really quickly. So this here is Steve, Kansas City's finest muralist, and he's putting the finishing touches on the Monogram Lounge mural right here. You'll notice on the back bar we've got those draft towers. We've got six draft cocktails at any given moment. We also have resurrected Heim beer. It's being produced by KC Beer Co, and it's only available here. It's our single beer that we pour on draft, and you can't get it anywhere else in Kansas City. We chose KC Beer Co because Heim was a German family, and they were really known for their German lager. In fact, they won a number of awards back in the late 1800s, early 1900s for their German lager. And KC Beer Co is known for making German style beer, so we thought they were the perfect partner to recreate that for us. No matter where you are in the building, you can look over the top of the production, and it really kind of helps drive that point home that that's really the heart and soul of the business. It really gives you a perspective of the size and the scale. And from up here, you can even see the open top fermenters and what's happening in there. It's just really, really, really beautiful. So down these stairs here, we have kind of a secret, hidden little higher-end cocktail bar, kind of cozy and intimate. We call it the Hey Hey Club, which is a tribute to the 1930s jazz nightclub here in KC, where Count Basie was made famous. So let's go check that out. You know, cozy, dimly lit, a little bit more meticulous attention to detail in the cocktail production. Just a really beautiful, comfortable room. Got a fireplace here, bookshelves. We'll have furniture throughout the middle here, like Chesterfield couches and coffee tables. And we'll have the ability to have like a little jazz trio up here in the corner to kind of pay tribute to the Hey Hey Club days. It's a labyrinth. It just keeps going and going. Just within the last few weeks, we've gone from 10 employees, which we've taken about 5 years to get to now having more than 60 employees. And so this is an employee gym that they will have access to, as well as locker rooms, showers. So we wanted to make sure that our employees are, they're well taken care of and lead a balanced life. Being that we're a distillery and we're really focused on cocktails, ice is a really important thing. And so we have this room here dedicated to ice cutting, juicing, all that stuff. So we've got a couple Kleinbell machines. So basically what this does is it produces 4 25-pound blocks. It takes about 24 hours. And when they're done, we'll pull them out. We'll have a bandsaw in here, cut them up into smaller chunks, and then carve them into to 2x2 cubes for individual drinks. With the kind of the resurgence of the craft cocktail scene that we've seen over the last five or so years, is trying to figure out how to serve that level of cocktail in larger environments so we can serve large groups, 200, 300 people at a time. So in order to do that, we have to get innovative. And so we've actually built a 500 square foot walk-in dedicated to cocktails on tap. Each individual line, we run both carbon dioxide and nitrous to, or CO2 and N2O. And so we can switch the gases depending on the style of cocktail. It just makes it really user-friendly, really efficient, and really fast. Makes the ability to switch cocktails out when necessary really, really, really easy. So this is the old building that we've been operating out of for the last 5 years. What's going to happen in here, we've moved all of our production into the old Heim building. And in the middle here, we've built this really beautiful room that's going to be a hidden secret dining room in the middle of all the barrels. So we're going to surround this with barrels so that if you're walking in from the distillery, you won't know it's there. You'll just see barrels basically stacked everywhere. We're going to have the ability to store over 5,000 barrels here in this building. But if you kind of walk through the maze of barrels, you end up at the entrance to this room, which will have a big, beautiful table in the middle that will seat 16, and we'll be able to host private dinners, private cocktail parties, whiskey barrel sample tastings, all kinds of things like that. So it's going to be, I think this is going to be really, really fun and kind of an unexpected part of the experience. So we ran a separate independent HVAC just to that room so we can, you know, moderate the temperature in there. But this building is not temperature controlled by design, because whiskey actually thrives in extreme temperatures. So, you know, extreme swings from very, very cold to very, very hot, that's actually good for the aging of whiskey and barrel. All right, we're going back upstairs so that we can finish off the visit here the right way. And there's only one way to do that, and that's to go down the slide. All right, I'm doing it. It's the only way to leave.